after a bad game, especially a horrible quarter in Vilnius. Today we played, I would say, a good game, especially on defensive end. Everybody that played was ready to play with an aggressive mindset, and we are all very happy that the regular season is over and now we can get ready for the playoffs.
Po blogų rungtynių, ypač blogo kėlinio Vilniuje, šiandien sužaidėme tikrai geras rungtynes, ypač gynyboje. Visi žaidėjai buvo pasiruošę žaisti, nusiteikę agresyviai kovoti ir esame labai laimingi, kad baigėsi reguliarusis sezonas ir prasideda atkrintamasis.
Hello coach, could you say that you were happy with the team's energy and the aggressiveness for the whole 40 minutes today?
Yes. This is what I ask. This is what we discuss after Sunday bad loss, and we wanted to, you know, at this stage of the season, words count zero. Is what your actions speaks louder than your words. So we want to, after 72 hours, we wanted to show a different face. We did it, and we were locked in. We were focused. We played with the. I would say that we did mistakes, but the energy was totally different on both ends of court.
Ar esate patenkintas komandos nusiteikimu visas 40 minučių? Taip, to prašiau komandos, apie tai diskutavome po sekmadienio pralaimėjimo. Šioje sezono dalyje žodžiai nieko jau nebereiškia, viską parodo veiksmai, tad po 72 valandų norėjome parodyti kitą veidą ir tą padarėme. Buvome susikoncentravę ir nors darėme klaidų, bet energija buvo gera visą laiką.
Tomas Dimša had the best game since your arrival to Kaunas. Could you expand about his importance to the team and how is working with him for the past few months?
More than talking about how he's important to the team, that is obvious, and he's a Žalgiris kid, and I would like to talk more or how much he cares for our team. And sometimes he cares so much that he puts himself in second place, you know, and it was important for him. I did what I could to prepare him for this kind of game. He played very good. I don't look at the shot that he made. I'm very happy for him because this is a very good way to build self-confidence, but he was extremely focused, extremely solid on defense. I explained him before the game that it was the last game for him to find his role into the playoffs because he was out for a month, and he's a very smart person and he cares very much for our team, and I'm more than looking at his performance, and that obviously is there just to watch. I'm happy for him to find his game, that he found his game.
Klausimas buvo apie Tomą Dimšą, kuris šiandien sužaidė geriausias rungtynes prisijungus treneriui, kokia jo svarba komandoje. Treneris sakė, kad akivaizdu, kad jis yra Žalgirio vaikis, ką galiu pasakyti, kad jam labai rūpi komanda ir kartais rūpi tiek daug, kad jisai save pastato į antrą vietą po komandos. Šiandien nežiūrėjau jo metimus, nors tokie taiklus metimai, žinoma, pakelė žaidėjo pasitikėjimą, bet mane labai džiugino jo nusiteikimas, ypač gynyboje. Ir tai buvo jam proga po mėnesio nežaidus sugrįžti į ritmą ir nusistatyti savo rolę atkrintamosiomis. Džiaugiuosi, kad jisai atrado savo ritmą šiandien.
Playoffs are starting in Sunday, 4 days remaining. Is there any concerns or anything you would like to still improve as a team in particular?
No, because what is done now. We just have to play. Playoff is a different sport. You play the same thing multiple times. Adjustments are the key. You have to understand what is the best chemistry for your team, what's the best offense, what is the best defense, and then from game one, we're going to start. We know that whoever comes won't be easy because they are all going to be underdogs, play with the idea of being underdogs, so nothing to lose, everything to gain, and we got to prepare. It won't be an easy run, so we need to remember how many times we had to suffer this season, especially in EuroLeague, to survive.
Prasideda atkrintamosios sekmadienį, ar turite dar ką pagerinti? Tai treneris atsakė ne, kas padaryta, tas jau padaryta, tai lieka žaisti. Žaisime daug rungtynių su tais pačiais varžovais, tad svarbiausia yra prisitaikymas tiek gynyboje, tiek puolime. Nesvarbu, su kuo teks žaisti, vis tiek nebus lengva, nes varžovas neturės ką prarasti ir tai nebus lengvas pasivaikščiojimas. Todėl turime prisiminti, kiek šį sezoną turėjome kentėti EuroLygoje ir taip toliau.
So EuroLeague playoffs will conclude today.
If you let me go, I will watch it.
Yeah, one last question. Who is leading in Žalgiris staff's bracket for the EuroLeague?
If I give you this answer, I'm going to have to kill you. So better for you that I don't tell this.
Congratulations, Žalgiris. Okay, it's clear that level of game they have, especially level of physicality, it's a big point for and big difference, of course, that provoke a lot of turnovers for us and create a lot of easy points for them. So overall, both teams use this game, as I see, you know, to prepare for playoffs. And, you know, they try to use this opportunity for as a best preparation for Sunday game.
Sveikinimai Žalgiriui. Yra aiškus skirtumas tarp lygių, ypač fiziškumo lygis. Tas fiziškumas privertė mus daug klysti ir taip pat leido jiems pelnyti daug lengvų taškų. Manau, kad abi komandos išnaudojo šios rungtynes tiesiog pasiruošti atkrintamosioms ir sekmadienio kitam mačiui.
You saw any good things on the court?
Absolutely, it was a lot of good things. I can be only disappointed with the number of turnovers, especially unforced turnovers, and that we didn't use fouls, especially no bonus fouls or small fouls, we didn't use well. So this is first two things that I actually mentioned also for that we need to really work to improve. But overall, you know, there are a lot of good defensive reactions. There are some good reads in offense. Of course, today we didn't shoot the ball well. On the opposite side, Žalgiris today was very, very hot, especially Dimša, which is all normal or super for them. But overall, I say, you know, first of all, everybody got a good minutes. The let's say the tasks that we had for individual and team, more or less a lot of things that very good sign for us.
Klausimas buvo, ar matėte gerų dalykų šiandienos rungtynėse. Žinoma, buvo daug gerų momentų. Esu nepatenkintas tik klaidomis, ypač neišprovokuotomis, ir taip pat neišnaudojame pražangų iki bonuso. Tą minėjau ir žaidėjams, kad šitą turime atkreipti dėmesį ir pagerinti. Bet buvo taip pat ir gerų epizodų gynyboje. Reikia pripažinti, kad Žalgiris buvo karštas, ypač Tomas Dimša. O mūsų komanda visi gavo minučių ir daugiau ar mažiau įvykdė jiems keltas užduotis.
From scale 1 to 10, how Utena is prepared for playoffs?
I believe that you saw the last games we played, so this is evaluation. So this game for me for sure is not now that we need to evaluate, but the game that we played in the last time, this is the scale for us and level that we need.
Skalė nuo 1 iki 10, kaip yra komanda pasiruošusi atkrintamosioms. Tai matėte paskutinius mačius, tai jie turėtų būti tas lygis, kurį reiktų kreipti dėmesį, o ne šios dienos rungtynės.
Ivan Vraneš come back to team. Will he play in playoffs or not?
We will see. He's back to now to practicing, he's back to the team. We work every day, but decision about his chances to play or how, and it's about the next practices, so he will be here, so we'll see. It's a long break for him. Not easy to evaluate, but he's doing best. We do our best, and we'll see what next practices will give us.
Ivanas Vranešas grįžo į komandą ir žais atkrintamosiose. Jis neseniai grįžo į treniruotės ir matysime, koks jisai juose bus. Nuo to ir priklausys jo šansai žaisti rungtynėse. Buvo ilgoka pertrauka, bet jis stengiasi ir matysime treniruotėse jo progresą.
Hello, coach. You mentioned that you will evaluate Vranės chances to play. Is it related to the injury or with the suspension?
Suspension doesn't have anything with this. This is... He had a problem with the hands. It was difficult injury. So the only reason that he is out of the team for this long time, first of all is big injury that he had. Now seems that he's back better, not really fixed till end. It's an injury on the wrist, which is very difficult. And before that, he has also the joints on the fingers. So this is very difficult, especially for the bigs that they are in a physical contact. They need to grab rebounds and so on and so on. So this is the only matter for him. This what was suspended, it was a lack of some things that he breaks some internal rules, but this is what we already commented. So there is nothing related to this. It's only about his now physical status and the level of basketball that he can perform with the problem that he has.
Klausimas buvo, ar Vranešo galimybė žaisti yra susijusios su trauma ar su suspendavimu. Tai treneris atsakė, kad tik tai su trauma, jisai turėjo tikrai sudėtingą rankos traumą, dabar jaučiasi geriau, nors nėra iki galo pasveikęs, ypač didelėms žaidėjams yra sudėtingos tokios traumos, nes jie ir daugiau grumės ir kovoja dėl kamolių, todėl dabar svarbiausia fizinė forma.
In an interview with the LKL, you said that the fourth place in the regular season was like a dream to you. Since you already reached it, what's the new dream?
Keep dreaming, so making the next step. So I said, for this, our small organization, for all, I think that achieving this position in the regular part is really good achievement and good success, and this belongs to everybody. And I think from that point, we all need to be satisfied how the season was, not only in the LKL, but we had pretty good also international promotion of the club, and right now we all want to prepare best as possible for playoff and try to make a next step. So
viename
dream zone.
Viename interviu minėjote, kad ketvirta vieta yra kaip svajonės įsipildymas, kokia yra nauja svajonė. Tai mes norime svajoti ir toliau. Tokiai mažai organizacijai tikrai nudirbome gerą darbą. Esame patenkinti šiuo sezonu ne tik LKL, bet ir užsienio turnyre. Dabar turime ruoštis ateities kovoms.